Now, based on how old a royal number one is, I bet this hasn't caught a mouse in over 100 years, but we're gonna change that tonight. Well, it does look like a giant mouth with sharp teeth. Chomp, chomp, chomp. Today for Mousetrap Monday, we're gonna catch a mouse in the barn with the all-time rarest and most valuable mousetrap I have in my collection. If you're not familiar with my channel, I post videos on YouTube where I test out different mousetrap designs. I have a collection with over 1,000 different examples, everything from new and modern mousetraps to very old and rare ones, and this definitely falls in that last category. It's a cast iron mousetrap, and on it, it's printed number one royal. Down here's a date. It was first patented by James M. Keep of New York, New York on November 4th, 1879. And one reason it's so valued by collectors is its wicked but elegant design. Not only does it have those giant teeth in front, but it also has an elegant heart shape incorporated in the cast iron lattice pattern. Now, any American-made cast iron mousetrap from the 1800s, especially one with a patent date that is in working condition, is going to be worth a lot of money and highly prized by collectors. In the past, they have sold at auction for around $2,000 to $2,500, but the price has gone up, and this one is worth at least $3,000 or more. The way you catch a mouse with it is, there's an upper jaw made out of cast iron, a lower jaw that hinges right here, two springs that aren't overly powerful, and in the middle here is a trigger. To set it, you pull this upper jaw back and hook it in with the trigger. Now when a mouse tries to get the bait on the trigger, those big teeth will clamp down on the mouse's head. You can see the heart right there with the fur in it. Now based on how old a royal number one is, I bet this hasn't caught a mouse in over 100 years, but we're gonna change that tonight. Now I can't show a mouse getting chomped down with big teeth on YouTube, so I built a box for our trap. It's a wooden tunnel with a screen in the back so we can see the trap. I'm gonna set it back here. The mouse is gonna enter, try to get the bait, and when it does, it will get caught. Now before I place our trap in the barn, I have a safety measure. I placed a nail right there. That way, it fits the loop of the back of the trap. We can set it on there, and nothing can pull it away. Worst case scenario is, I can't find my mouse trap. It would disappear. So hopefully that nail holds it in place. Now I have had a problem in the past with a squirrel stealing a trap. Luckily, that was only a $20 trap, but it was still a collector's item, and you never know what squirrels will do. So hopefully nothing happens. Let's set our trap, put bait on the trigger, and see if we can catch a mouse. Now I do have to admit, I was pretty nervous to leave a $3,000 mousetrap sitting on the floor in the barn. I didn't want a squirrel, a pack rat, or even a human to come and steal my trap. I set up one of my trail cameras at the door just in case that thief that was here a year ago returned. But overall, the trap worked. The mouse went in there, hit the trigger, and those jaws closed on it. This may be the first mouse caught by a royal number one in over 100 years, and I'm going to retire it and never set it up again. It's going in a safe place, but first I have to remove this mouse. I'm not going to let it go to waste. Instead, I'm going to feed it to wild animals in my backyard. So let's go set up the motion cameras and see what comes along and enjoys a mouse caught in a $3,000 mouse trap. Well, I was wondering if one of the turkeys in my backyard would gobble down a dead mouse, but they didn't. Instead, the skunk missed out because a raccoon got there first and enjoyed a very expensive mouse meal. Overall, I'm excited to add such a rare and valuable antique mousetrap to my collection. But believe it or not, even though the Royal No. 1's a top prize, it's not the rarest and most valuable. There's many more examples I'd love to get my hands on, but they're just not available. I wasn't even able to buy this one with money. I had to find another collector willing to part with one, and I had to do trades. I traded some of my best rat traps for this one mousetrap, but to me it was way worth it, and hopefully I can add some more rare mousetraps in the near future. Thank you so much for watching my videos, and thanks to all the viewers who have sent me art. I love seeing the pictures. If you haven't subscribed, please consider clicking that button. I've posted over 600 videos on YouTube, and currently I'm posting new videos every Monday and Friday. So if you want to see the best videos on how to catch mice, rats, squirrels, chipmunks, moles, voles, and gophers, stay tuned.